My name is Emily, and I'm here today to talk to you about gratitude. Gratitude is the appreciation of benefits that we get from other people and our expression of thanks. And a way that we can put gratitude into practice is by recognizing all the things that we may take for granted, such as the ability to actually go to school, play outside with our friends, practice sports. All these things that make our lives so enjoyable that are being taken away from us right now. It really is the time to be grateful for all the things that you do have in your life.
Hi guys, I'm here to talk to you today about grit, my favorite character strength. Grit is defined as having the perseverance and the passion to achieve your long-term goals, and this can kind of be applied to what we're going through right now. None of us expected the spring to go the way it is now. Many of us were excited to attend events that recently were canceled, like sports games or recitals or even the Shine On conference, but we can't let this get us down. We had to continue playing and continue practicing and continue planning because there will always be another game, another recital, and another Shine On conference. So when life throws another challenge your way, practice grit and tackle it head on to continue achieving your future goals.
Marie here from Shine On. What does zest mean? Zest means energetic and enthusiastic participation in life. A zesty girl makes the most out of any situation and always carries on with a smile. So instead of being bummed about anything you might be missing because of this pandemic, try to be zesty and get excited about all the new things you can try during this time. Like, for example, spending more time outside in your backyard.
Hey everyone! We're going to be talking about optimism today, and what optimism means is to be hopeful that you'll be successful. It means that you need to be confident about what will happen in your future because of all of the hard work you're putting into that today. An example of this is, let's say you have a spelling quiz coming up and you've been studying for this quiz all week, but you've still been feeling like you're not going to do that well on the quiz. You've been having a negative mindset. To be optimistic means to have a positive mindset on that quiz. You're going to do amazing on that quiz because of all of the hard work and studying you've been doing. Instead of being negative and thinking you're not going to do well, you should be positive. Think you're going to do amazing. If you think you're going to do well and you put in the hard work to do well, you're going to be successful. And that's what optimism is.
Social intelligence is understanding the way people are feeling and then adjusting your actions accordingly. This is so important during this pandemic because everyone is social distancing, which means that everyone's kind of stuck in their house. Everyone's lives aren't the same. No one's going in and out doing what they usually do. So a lot of emotions are going a little crazy. Because of this, understanding why people are acting the way they are is so important, not just to you, but to everyone else around you. So try and practice social intelligence today because it will make all the difference.
Hi, my name is Aisha from the Shine On Committee, and the character strength that we're going to focus on right now is curiosity. The coronavirus has really just taken over our lives and turned it on our heads. Although this is something that can be easily misunderstood, it's our responsibilities to exhibit our curiosity and figure out what is going on. It's important to Google these buzzwords that we hear all the time, like pandemic, quarantine, and social distancing. It's also important to search up on the virus itself. Do your part by searching up from a reliable source, of course, what the virus is and what the symptoms are. Obviously, we all hear little tads and bits of information, but it's important to truly understand it for ourselves.
Hi girls, so today we're going to be talking about self-control.
Even the dog can practice self-control.
Self-control is making sure you do the things you need to do first before you do all the fun things you want to do.
Maddie and I have been practicing self-control by doing all of our classes and homework.
Some things you can do to practice self-control during this time would also be doing your homework before you want to watch TV, or making sure you eat healthy during this time, and you can also make sure you don't go out and hang out with your friends, even though I know you really might want to, but it's important to stay home right now.
We challenge you to practice self-control.